Now you've heard of foolish questions, and no doubt you've wondered why. How a person who should ask such foolish questions should expect the same reply. Now did you ever bring your sweet little girl a box of candy after tea, and then notice how she grabs it and then says, "Is this for me?" 'Tis a foolish question you should answer when you can. No, sugar, I brought it for your father, for your mother. No, it's for John, your hired man. I just brought it so you can see it. And now I'm gonna take it all away. That's a question you can hear most every day. Suppose most every morning there's somebody lurking around your place that'll see you take a shaving brush and lather up your face. And as you're about to give that razor its preliminary wave, the first fool who approaches will say, "Are you going to take a shave?" 'Tis a foolish question, and your answer is, I hope, no. I ain't at all prepared for shaving. I just enjoy the taste of soap. I just like to take this here shaving brush and paint my face this sort of way. Now, that's something that you can hear most every day. Elevator boy should forget to close his doors, and you should tumble down some elevator shaft past 26 and 27 floors. And after you reach the bottom and you're lying there all inert, the next fool who approaches will say, "Oh, buddy, are you hurt?" Foolish question, and your dying words will be, "Oh, no. I was just in an awful hurry, and this elevator runs too goddamn slow. And I found I saved a lot of time by coming down this here way." Now, that's the kind of question you can hear most